Hello friends, I am Shyam Tamankar. I welcome you all to an audio-visual program of learning MSPT LEAD, Learning at Your Doorstep. Now here we are going to deal with Course Outcome 2, Unit Outcome 3, Part C. Now what is this UO3? Part C about? It is for understanding how to prepare a manpower budget for the given production activity. Now, what is the agenda of this part? We'll have to understand objective of manpower planning. We'll see what is HR budget. Then we'll see information required to create HR budget. We'll discuss one real life example of manpower budget calculations at shop floor, and we'll look at the references. Now we have already discussed at length about this quote, so I need not repeat it. So let us understand objectives of manpower planning. So the objective of manpower planning is to plan and regulate. So it is essentially for planning and regulating what selection and recruitment, training and competence building, career planning and other human resource activities, and all this is to be done at the right time and with the right people to meet organization's short-term and long-range objectives. Now, human resource, as you know, is very important or highly important or key to the success of the organization. Here, in this unit, we are more concerned about the manpower planning and budgeting at shop floor. Now, the labor necessities in various job categories such as unskilled, semi-skilled and supervisory are determined with the help of all the head of the department. So, head of the departments or the sections are basically involved in budgeting the requirement of the unskilled, semi-skilled or the supervisory level employees. The labor employment is made keeping in view the requirement of the job. So what you have to first understand or decide, you have to decide first the job requirement, and means what is expected from the employee, what is the requirement from the employee if he wants to fulfill that job. Okay, so that is derived from the job description. Now, when you say requirement, that means what is the qualification required or the degree of the skill required or the experience required by that person for that particular job. And the other important is the rate of pay which is to be paid to that employee. Now, we'll understand HR budget. The budgeting for manpower requirement refers to the funds that HR allocates to all HR processes enterprise-wide. Now you know already that budgeting means allocation of the funds. So here we are dealing with the funds which are allocated by HR, or means the funds allocated to HR and then how HR allocate the funds to the different activities. The HR budget will include funds allocated to 1. Hiring, that is selection and recruitment. 2. Salaries and benefits. 3. Talent management and training. 4. Succession planning and employee welfare and wellness planning. So all these points I need not explain, they are very much self-explanatory. So HR budgets use financial information, performance results and historical data from every department. As the HR budgets consider HR activities company-wide, it is complex yet essential document to determining a company's future HR activity. So, it is pertaining to the future period, and you consider what will be the future activities, what will be the employee requirement, and accordingly you do the budget and you document it. Now, what is the information required to create a HR budget? So we'll have to forecast on number of employees. We'll have to understand the employee turnover rate, that means how many employees leave the organization in a given period. So accordingly you have to employ the new people. This is called as the attrition rate. Then very importantly, the salary data, because you are paying salary to all the people, and so every employee's salary details must be with you. Then recruitment budget, that means how much money will be required to recruit the people. New benefits program means if you are going to have a new benefit program for the period you are budgeting, then you have to consider that. Then you have to consider the expenses on the training and development. Then you have to consider the payroll cost, that means the cost creation of the payroll. You have to consider the overtime which is to be given to the employees. You have to project on that, how much overtime will be required to be paid in the coming period. It will depend on the production budget or the production schedules. Then incentive compensation, so whatever the incentives are to be paid individually and collectively. Then you must have the HR database. HR database includes all the data pertaining to all the employees. So all this information is required whenever you create an HR budget. Now, in short and simply, we'll try to understand how we calculate budget at shop floor, which is required for you people. It is important for you to understand this. So consider a situation where a customer wants a product P at the rate of 5000 units per day. Means you are going to supply a product P at the rate of 5000 units per day to a customer. This product P has three operations, means it has to undergo three operations, A, B, C, and the time required or the man minutes required for each operation is 5, 8 and 6 minutes respectively. Now the company works for 2 shifts per day and working time per employee is 420 minutes, that is per shift, and it works for 25 days per month. Now normal efficiency of operations of the company is 85%. Each worker's salary is rupees 500 per day. Now how to calculate on the basis of this data? Demand of P per day in numbers is 5000. Man minutes per product time T is equal to 5 plus 8 plus 6 is equal to 19 minutes. Working time per employee is 420 minutes. Number of shifts per day is 2. So manpower required per shift per day is equal to 5000, the units produced, into 19 minutes required per job per unit produced, divided by 420 minutes, the working time of the employee, and 2 shifts. So 5000 into 19 divided by 420 divided by 2 is equal to 113.09 employees. So manpower required per shift per day considering 85% efficiency is equal to 113.09 divided by 0.85 is equal to 133.04 is equal to 134 numbers. So in the situation, this company needs 134 people per shift and 268 people per day for satisfying its customer demand. Everyday salary will be rupees 500 into 268 equal to rupees 1,34,000. Per month salary budget will be rupees 1,34,000 into 25 is equal to rupees 33,50,000. So you can very well understand by this example how the manpower budgeting is done in a particular section by supervisor and his immediate boss. Now the references are learning manual by MSBTE, and there are other two links. You can log on to those two links and try to understand about the manpower planning and budgeting further. So thank you friends, thank you very much. Now we'll meet again when we'll discuss about UO4, that is unit outcome 4 of course outcome 2. Thank you, thanks a lot.